This is the painting we are going to do today. A beautiful landscape with a beautiful windy day. We have a little girl standing in the field holding onto her hat. And I'm going to make this as easy as I can for you. The paints I'm going to use today are ultramarine blue, cad yellow, cad red, burnt sienna and burnt umber, and titanium white. You can use any colors that you have as long as you get to blue, red, yellow, and burnt sienna is a brown with a red. You can make your own, and burnt umber is a dark brown. And the brushes I am going to use are a long liner brush, and you can use a small round brush, and I'm using a bristle brush. It's a size 8, and I have a fan brush, and that's a bristle, and I have a chiseled edge synthetic filbert brush. So the first thing I think will be best to start is with the sky. A nice purplish color sky. It makes it kind of look like it's getting ready to get a little stormy and windy. So all you have to do is take your bristle brush. You could also use a synthetic brush if you like. I'm going to make a purplish color for the sky. So I'm just going to take my ultramarine blue and some red. Mix it together, get dark purple, more on the blue side. And I'm going to add some white. You get that really nice purplish color sky. Fill up your brush. And then we'll decide how high up we want to go. So I'm thinking probably, let's see. Probably a third the way down. And then just take your brush and start putting on your purple sky. What you want to do is get the top part of that nice and dark. Let's go back and forth. Back and forth. Long strokes. Back and forth. That'll give you a nice smooth sky. Now pick up white on your dirty brush. I put that underneath there, and then you can come back up into your... As long as everything is wet, you should get a really nice sky. We'll darken that if we have to. What I'm trying to do is get the darks and some lights in there at the same time. There we go. Pick up some more of your dark color. And some white. And on there. See how you're getting some white and darks? By adding white. Now we'll add white again. On your dirty brush. Good. And white. Dirty brush. Let me pick up a little more of that dark color just to get some shadow down here. See, that didn't take very long. We'll put in some white streaks after. Here. Just to have the corners a little darker. That's all, just get some nice shadows in there. So that's good for the sky for now, and we'll be putting in some clouds and a few things after. We'll just get something started. Now clean your brush or get a new one, and we will start with some dark. Let's start with a bit of burnt umber. Alright, just a bit of tap into a bit of burnt umber with your bristle brush. Okay, just get some darks down here. We'll start at the bottom and work our way up. Just tap, 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 tap. This is your underpainting for your grass. A bit up the side here. Move back over here. Good. Just tapping on your dark grass first. And as we come up, we'll add more colors so we can get it nice and bright. So just keep working the burnt umber. Good. Good. Now, with your dirty brush, tap into some of your burnt sienna. Okay. Get lighter and lighter as we go up. Start over here. We'll come across again. And even tap down into your burnt umber, just so it'll all blend together. A nice color. I love burnt sienna. I never used to use it very much before, so I was always making my own burnt sienna. It never came out as pretty as this. It's only brown with some red added to it. You can come down into your burnt umber just so that'll all blend. You don't have too many lines. Let's see, how high will we go? Let me see. Let's go up a little further. So just tap away so you can get that texture. Come across. So you're trying to make some decisions now, how you're going to go and where you're going to put everything. We can start adding. Let's see. What else can we add? Let's see, maybe some yellow. Dirty brush. Tap into your yellow. And tap on the yellows. See, now you can come right down into that because you want the colors to mix. It's okay. It's great when everything's all wet, so if you keep working and you go get a cup of tea and you come back, it's all dry. You might have to start working your colors back in. want to add a little bit of burnt sienna to that. Let's get a little bit of dark shadows in there. We don't want it just a plain color. More yellow. So go back and forth with your colors. You don't have to worry about when I'm, you know, you can use me as a guide, but play with your colors and don't worry if you make a mess down here, you can start over. No, you don't want to do that. I don't blame you, but if you have to, at this point you can, if you have to start over, you can. Well, you shouldn't have to. Just go back over the colors. I'm just making these look like little trees up here. Okay. Good. I'll put a second coat on that in a second. Tree shape up here like this. Give it a few little humps. Stop that. Now you can see that line there, but I'll take that out. So in the center here, we want to keep it nice and bright, so we'll add more yellow to our brush. Brush is dirty, so it's picking up some of the orange. See how I'm going over some colors? I'm just tapping. All we're concerned with now is getting really nice colors. I'm gonna finish this off right here. There we go, that's pretty. Just going over a few places where leftover paint on my brush. There we go. That's pretty, isn't it? So we'll go over this again so that we can hide that little line that I put there. So maybe you better put a lighter line there. I put a dark one there. Now I got to deal with it. See? I'm just going over it again. Now I'm going to add a little bit of white to that mixture I have there of the yellow and red. Just to tap on a little bit of highlight up here on top of those trees. Just so they won't look so flat. Remember your three values. There you go. Now we'll use our fan brush to get more of a grassy look. Okay, so what we'll do is, we'll add a little more white and a little bit of yellow. my brush, my dirty brush. Right. Make sure it's not too much on there. You don't want big blobs. Just holding my brush like this. Tapping. Tapping the very top of the brush. Trees over on the edges here just to add some little interest to the painting. And I'm going to use, you can use sap green, or you can take your ultramarine blue, a little bit of yellow, make it dark green. A little more on the blue side so it won't be too light. And tap it off on your palette just to make sure that it's not too much paint on your brush. So we'll start right here. We'll just fill that in over here. Just want a little top on it there. It's going to make a smaller tree over here. There we go. Branches sticking out on the edge here. Just by moving your brush out. There we go, that's a good tree. Alright, now I'm going to do the other side with some more ultramarine blue and yellow, a little dark. And so we can add a little bit of burnt umber to that if you like, just to darken it again. All right, let's try a tree over here. A little taller, let's say. So you can start on the inside here and then work your way out. Then you can get some. Fighting me all the way. There we go, that's good. Let's make some adjustments if you want to shape up your tree a little more. Good. And then I'm going to add a little bit of yellow to my dirty brush. A little bit of yellow to my dirty brush. I'm going to add a little bit, a little tiny bit over on this tree, just here and there, just so that some of the yellow still comes through, or the green still comes through. You don't want to lose your green. Maybe a little bit over here, just on the here and there. That sort of shapes up your tree a little more, see? Dabs. You don't want to lose the darkness of your tree. Okay, good. I'm gonna take my filbert brush. I'm gonna add a bit of white to my filbert brush. It's a pretty clean brush. I'm going to find some darks on here so I can put in little clouds. Let's see. On a shadow, and then add a little bit of a cloud underneath the shadow. Drag it over. That's all. Drag it over underneath the shadow, see? No need to have too much paint. Just a little bit up here. Underneath here. Just looking for the shadows, and I'm going underneath the shadow. Right? Just want to put some interest in the sky. Smooth them out a little bit. So you can widen them up a little bit, make it a little more natural. Soften this one up a little bit underneath. See, that gives more of an interest to your sky. Anything left over, just make some faraway clouds up here, wherever you want them. Just by going back and forth, see? No need to worry. Don't worry about your clouds too much. People get caught up in not making the perfect cloud, but clouds are not perfect. You look in the sky, you can see that they're floating everywhere. I'm just putting in some lines. It's all underneath the dark. Just scrubbing back and forth. Now that should do that. So next we will take our pattern that I will have for you, and you can draw it out. You can draw it freehand, or you can use the pattern that I give you, and you just tape it on with your masking tape, your painter's tape. And I'm going to use carbon paper to transfer the pattern to the canvas. I just put it underneath like this, and I get a pen and I draw out all the lines that I need. I press pretty hard because it's sometimes where the paint, make sure the paint is really, really dry, because if it's sticky, it won't take it. And then you got your pattern of your girl drawn onto your canvas, ready to paint. You take that off, and you can redraw the lines with a pen if you like, or a marker, because you can paint over the lines if they're hard to see. So just paint over the lines as you do them. If you're having a hard time, get them to come through really good. You should be able to see that. See? Now we could have put the girl out first and then painted around her. I've done that a couple of times. It's a little bit harder depending on your background. If your background is just plain, then you can do that. But if you've got grasses and trees and all kinds of things going on, it might be a little harder to get around, but you can do it. You can do it both ways. I like doing it this way. The paints I'm going to use today are ultramarine blue, cad yellow, cad red, burnt sienna and burnt umber, and titanium white. You can use any colors that you have, as long as you get to blue, red, yellow, and burnt sienna is a brown with a red. You can make your own, and burnt umber is a dark brown. And the brushes I am going to use are a long liner brush, and you can use a small round brush. And I'm using a bristle brush. That's a size 8. And I have a fan brush. And that's a bristle. And I have a chiseled edge synthetic filbert brush. I'm going to take my small filbert brush. Now you can use a small flat brush if you like, or a small round brush. Any brush that's fairly small. But whatever you find works for you, okay? I'm only making suggestions. As long as your brush is small enough to... There we go. And you might need two coats. As long as your brush is small enough to fit in to your painting. So I'm just going to put the pink on first. You can have any colors you want. You can color her head blue, which is nice and complementary to the orange and the purples. And you can use the pink, you can use red, whatever color hat you want. Even green might be nice. Okay, so then we'll go over the lines. I'm not gonna worry about the lines right now. Just wanna get the hat painted first. All right. So I'm using my pink color. Just red and white. All right. Use their highlights after. Let's just get, main thing is to get on the basic color first, and we can worry about the highlights after we get this done. Don't mind keeping the lines there right now because I might get a little lost if I don't have the lines, so don't worry about the lines right now. Keep the lines, you'll be able to see where everything goes. It's just too big. Just get a small round brush. This brush is not bad because it's chisel edge and it's round like filbert, so it's got a nice roundness to it where it can get into those rounder parts. Little big for in here. Okay, good. See, now you got that much done. There we go. We'll put another coat on there, I think. So, next is, let's see. Let's do her arm and her hair next. So we're gonna get some flesh tone, which we will make flesh tone out of white. A little bit of burnt sienna, a little bit of yellow, I think, small bit of red. And there's a nice flesh tone there. All right, let's start with that one. We're gonna put some shadow on there, so that's okay. That's a bit light. See how it's covering up all that underpainting that you did? That's a good thing. Sometimes you might need two coats. Okay, we got that much done. Let's see. I'm going to add some burnt sienna to that mixture for a shadow. All right. Let's put a shadow under here. Left side. It's not dark enough that you can put more on. I'm not going to worry too much right now about certain things because I just want to get started. Some people say, I don't know where to start. I don't know what to do. I'm just, it's confusing. Just get started. Get started somewhere. Just put some paint on. Let's watch things happen. Like when I was doing this painting first, because I practiced the first, the one I showed you earlier, and I had to figure out where I was going to start. So I gotta start somewhere. That's when I started with the sky. I had to figure it out somehow. cleaning off my brush really good and have no paint on it. So I can just smooth that out into the arm so it won't be a line there. It'll all blend nicely. So we might need to do a second coat or, you know, add a few little things after. We'll see. You have to wait for, almost all of it, not all of it, but a lot of it to be done in order so you can see how it's coming together. Because sometimes people, they try a part and then it's like, that don't look very good. I don't like the way it looks. But if you do more of the painting, move on with your painting, then you'll be able to see how it's coming together. All right. I'm going to put some burnt umber in our hair. So burnt umber to get started. Always look for the darkest part first. Get that. I'll pull out a few little hairs on the edges here just to make her hair look like it's blowing around. You can have it as long as you want. A little bit down here too. Right, so you can have it whatever way you want. At least this will get it started. I'm going to use my filbert, I think. Flat or filbert, it's fine. And I'm going to use on her dress, I'm going to put shadows there. So the best shadow I'm going to put there is some blue. Or be purple, but I'm going to use blue and white. See? So I got to start somewhere. I'm not really sure what would look better, but I want to get something here. So I'm going to, because I'm going to use that for shadow. And now I'll be able to get the shape of the dress. But you need to get the shape, so you need to fill them in. That's why you need to fill those. Fill in the drawing with color, even if it's not the color you're going to use. Just fill in some color so you can see the shape. Once you get the shape, then you're all set to go. All right. Just blue, a bit of white. Okay. Might need a couple of coats. So just remember that now. If you're doing any shapes, just put some color in there. Put something in there because you can always go over it with other colors just so you can find the shape. Don't worry about the color right away. It's the shape that you want to get. Whether it's a flower, a tree, a person, no matter what it is, just put some color. And then you can always go back over it with more color after. If you're doing, say you're doing sunflower, and you're concerned about, you know, maybe the yellow, you know, and I gotta put some shadows in and some yellows. But instead of worrying about all that, put just your yellow in there, or any color. It could be burnt sienna, whatever, anything at all. Put something in there to get that shape. And when you see the shape of your flower, then you can start adding on the colors that you want to use. So let's just keep, I'm doing sort of two coats because the underpainting is coming through a little bit. Paint over that line if you like. And it doesn't have to be perfectly straight on the edge here because it is blowing around, so. Already it looks pretty. Do the top part there now too. Let's see. Not sure, but I think I hear somebody saying, could you do the shirt first and put the hair on after? Yes, you can. Whatever works for you. Whatever works. I'm going to clean my brush. Clean my brush. Put a little bit of pink on the ribbon there so we can get that straightened away. So let's go with some pink for the ribbon for around her waist here. I'll leave that line there for now. There we go. See, already it looks pretty. Nice. All that dry, and probably do some more highlights and lowlights and things. While I'm waiting for that, we're going to do some grassy areas down here. So you see, sometimes I'm kind of moving around the painting, letting some parts dry, making decisions, and all that good stuff. So I'm going to, let's see. I'm going to put some yellow on here, a little bit of burnt sienna, and some white. So once you get your palette there, once you get your palette, your paint on your palette, those colors I told you, or your primary colors, plus white and burnt sienna. Once you got that, you're going to be using the same colors over and over again. So you don't have to worry about, I got to get my bottle of pink, and I got to get my bottle of green, and I got to get, you know, they're all on your palette. You don't need to get different color greens. You can add different colors to your greens to make them more darker or lighter. So I'm just running through my yellow and my burnt sienna, my white. Let's give me a nice color there. There we go. So I'm just going to the left, going to the right. Add a little bit of water to your brush just to get it moving. I'm not going to put up around her dress yet because I want to get those colors in there. I just want to get something going here. Moving around a painting like this is nice because you're not stuck in one place. I've seen people, some of my students sometimes would stay at one area for almost an hour, just probably paint the cloud or a bit of grass or whatever, and that can be pretty tedious, boring, and frustrating. So I find if you move around, it'll make it more interesting for you. And then when you come back to that area, then you'd be happy to come back to that area. Okay? Little water. A little water makes it move, see? Try not to push too hard like I'm doing there. I'm trying to get a thinner line than that. It's a nice long brush. It should be able to give me some nice thin lines. And when you're working on different parts of your painting and you start seeing it come to life, then you're more happy working on it. Right? You know what I mean? If you were just continuously working on the sky and you couldn't get it right and you were frustrated and you just kept sticking with that until you'd give up on your painting probably, you know? So just do what you can and then move on and then come back to it after. Then you can see what are the things it needs then. Little bits of grass here and there. Gives it a more realistic look. Or more interest, if you want to call it that too. I'm going to add a little bit of blue to my colors, yellow and white, and burnt sienna, just so I can get some different tones and tints and shades, all kinds of good stuff. The white is what really brings it out though. See that? See when I add white to my colors? Makes it pop. See that? See, now just a little bit more here. Sometimes when you see things going really well, you don't want to stop in that area. So if that makes you happy, that's fine. Just twisting them back and forth so that they look like they're blowing in the wind too, right? So the wind seems to be blown this way. Let's bend a few over this way so it looks like there might be a bit of wind going on there. Looks better. Let's add a few of those little white flowers that are there. I'm going to take, I didn't introduce this brush here, because you can use the smaller bristle brush that I introduced earlier. You can use that. I'm going to use this one because it's my favorite. See how it opens up? That's the 1-inch bristle. I'm going to tap that into some white. Throw in a little bit of that lavender color just so it won't be too yet white. Add a few little, tap off some excess paint if you have to. And I'm going to tap into some of these little flowers just to give them these little white ones that are sticking around here. There we go. Turn my brush a little here, way back and forth like that. These are just some flowers in the field. And my brush does what I need to do. I don't have to worry about it too much. My brush does all the work for me. My favorite brush. I mentioned it in my other videos, but it's just that brush that I have my name on. I put my name on it in case you guys want one. Sort of like a souvenir, but you can still use it to paint with, right? So, just to show you, that's all. So, so might be a few little flowers to here. You can put colors, you can put whatever colors you want there. A few little ones in the field. Down some white to brighten it up. There we go. Let's see where else we need them. Maybe there's a couple little ones up here somewhere. Maybe, I don't know. Have a look around, see. I'm gonna leave that like that. Okay, now what are we gonna work on? Let's work on the girl. We don't have much more left to do, you know. It's pretty fast painting, wasn't it? So all we have to do now is just to highlight some bit of color in her dress. And it's done. That didn't take very long. I might be able to get 2 lessons out of this instead of 3 or 4. Alright, so I'm going to highlight her. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to give that hat another coat. Another coat of pink. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. A little more on the red side than pure pink. Just to give it some, there'll be some shadow color then. So let's see. Yeah, some more on the red color side. So red with a little bit of white. And we'll keep it so we can use that for shadow. Do our second coat. Now we want to go over the lines. You feel confident enough. We'll keep that line in there. Give this another coat. Keep that in mind because I'm going to go over it with a shadow. Alright. Okay, we're gonna get some color in here. So let's go with some white and some white. Let's go white first. I can get ready to line. I'll go back over here like this just so that I can get under that line there. There we go. I'm using the chiseled edge of my filbert brush. Filling this in down here. We'll get that shadow back there now. Alright, there we go. Go with the shape of the dress. Some more white. Your brush is dirty, that's good. It's got some red in it. It's a good thing. Get rid of that line. You can turn your brush the chiseled edge way. Turn your brush, you know, like that way and that way, okay? Just so you can get different strokes. I'm fine when I go down like this. I like to have my brush like this, vertical. See? Nice. I'm gonna get some more color for top part of our dress there. A little bit of purple and white. Fill that in. Use that line for a shadow in a minute. More white. A little white on the edge here. Pull that in a bit. And where else? Probably a little bit here. See, that brightens it up nice, doesn't it? Now we're going to go with some pink. Give some pink. Clean your brush if it gets too mucky. It's too mucky, clean it. You don't want the colors to be too weird. You want to ruin it. A bit of pink. I'm going to give it some blue now in a minute. Go with the color of her dress. Good. And now some of that blue or purplish color, doesn't matter. I'm gonna see where there's some shadows. I'm gonna take some of my blue, ultramarine blue. I'm going to see where it's shadow. So I can make the dress look like it's a little bit in here. Maybe a little bit here. A little bit here. Where else? Let's see. Maybe there's some here. Just trying to make it look like the dress has, shadows and give it some shape. Good. Now let's take our white dirty brush. Put some white back in there. Nice. I know you're probably saying, you went back over your blue again. We can put it back in. Just trying to make decisions right now, really. Just trying to see what I like and what it's starting to look like. You might have to go back and forth a few times to get what you're looking for. You know, you can have a pure white dress if you want, but make sure you put some shadow in there, some blue. You have to have some color to show Okay. All right. A bit more white on top. Now I'm skipping over the shadows and some of the pinks so I can keep them. On the edge here so I can give her that line. That's nice. That's pretty. So we have this highlighted up here. That looks pretty good. Maybe a little more highlight down here. A little bit of my shadow, so that's okay. I'll just put it back in. And I want more white here. That's where the sun is shining on the front of the dress and on our elbow and things, so we have to make sure we put, so I'm getting some more white, and I'm going to put some whites on the edge of her. That line. Go around here. A bit on her hand, on the top. On the edge, and where else? Okay, I went over the line, so I don't want to make a mess there. I'm going to go into my burnt sienna. A darker shadow. My dirty brush, but it's pretty dark. So I'm going to see if I can darken this side up a little more. That way I can get rid of that line. Paint over that line. Scrubbing it on. I don't want too much paint yet because it's easier to control when you don't have too much paint on your brush at this point. Underneath here. Most light is at the top.
That's better.
So you need a small brush to get rid of those lines. So, as for the lines in the hat, I'm going to use blue and red to make purple. I'm going to use, try to filbert, if that don't work, I'll get the small liner brush out. Okay, just be careful. One, two. See, it's got a chiseled edge, so it's pretty good.
That's nice.
Add a little bit of trim here, too. It's the bow. Wipe off my brush a little bit with just so much paint on it, and I'm going to bring some of that shadow down here. Just a little bit, not much. A little bit up here. Not too much. I think we're good. And let's see. Brush a little bit, get some white, bring a little. little bit of a light in here. Too light. So I'm going to go back and get a little bit of red. Too much. There we go. It's better. A little bit on the bow.
Good.
It's coming along. A little bit of light pink on the edge here. This is a highlight, maybe a little bit of highlight up on the hat here. Too much paint, be careful of that. When you're adding some small areas of highlight, just have very little paint on your brush, okay? Smooth off that edge so you don't have a hard edge. And where else can we put a bit of highlight? Maybe a little bit in here. And a little bit on the rim here. Okay, watch the paint. Watch it. Okay, and some in here. Just trying to make everything flow nicely. Get some more pink.
That looks good. Her dress is pretty.
All right.
So if you want to get rid of those little lines, and you can't do it with that, try to get a small brush, a very small round brush that you can control. Maybe one like this. And wherever you're trying to get rid of the lines, put the color on it that's on the head or wherever you're trying to work on it. And I'm using the hat, so I'm trying to get rid of this line here, so I'll use this little, and I'll just paint over it with the pink color. See? And that will help you get rid of the lines. And the lines don't look too bad, but if you don't want them there, just go over them. Shadow around her finger. That's okay. That's okay. There's really not much. I got rid of most of the lines. I did pretty good there. So now you can add a bit more white to the dress just to brighten it up a little bit. It kind of gives it that nice. Brings out the other colors even more. She also has some little pink ribbon hanging down there. Let's see. To imagine the way it's falling there. Just using the filbert. There we go. And she has, I'm going to use the back of my brush and put some red and blue together. Kind of a dark purplish color. Use the back of my brush for this. I'm gonna put that right here as a little round thing holding our dress together. See? Right there. Good. The only thing, you know, I like the ribbon the way it is. I don't think it needs much trim. Put trim on it if you like, but I think I'm going to leave that. Alright. So we'll use our long liner brush again. And we will
make some flowers and stems and
all kinds of goodies going up there. So let's do the yellow and the burnt sienna, some white.
And we will take some grass right up into our dress. All right. It's okay to have a little, a couple of big ones there so you can see them. Because the dress is light, we'll put a darker piece of grass in there. Might need some water. Good. I'm using burnt sienna because the dress is light, so I'm trying to get the grass so you can see it. Burnt sienna, a bit of yellow. Little bits of grass. Try a bit of white to get that to move. It doesn't want to move. You know what? If you're having a hard time with your brush, let's change brushes.
I'm going to try this longer one that I used before. See if that will move. Let's see. It's better. See? You thought it was you. Not you at all. Get your paint. The more you layer your grass, the nicer it looks, do you find? Because the acrylics, they dry dark, so you put on all these really bright colors and then it starts to dry and you're like, where's my old color gone? So you have to layer it again, more color. Because I know you're saying, well, what's the remedy for that? That's the remedy. More color on. See all those pretty, pretty grasses? Isn't that pretty? All going up around her dress. I like to get a little darker ones down here so you can see them. Just going over what I did to darken them up a little bit. And I'm just going to take the same old brush and I'm just going to add a few little bit of red, white, blue, whatever colors you want. Just add a few little flowers or something. Just tap little flowers here and there. Whatever colors you want. It can be red, it could be yellow. A few little here. Whatever colors you want. Just use the same brush. All you do is make these little touches. Touch, touch, touch. Your brush will do the job for you. You don't have to do anything, just put paint on it, that's all. And decide where you want your flowers. You have to make that decision. Maybe there's a few little ones coming on up here. Just to make it look like the grass is coming up around the tree. Little dots there. Pretty, look like there might be some flowers back there. Maybe, I don't know. But
just trying to get it to all fit together, let it all come together. You know, look around, see where you think it might need extra. Right? Just a few little flowers maybe in back here, who knows? Who really knows? Now, one more thing. I'm going to use my burnt umber with my same brush. And put a few little dark areas down here just so that it'll bring out those lighter ones. Okay, so pure burnt umber. Your brush can be dirty, it's okay. Pure burnt umber. Get some darks down here to make all those other nice light ones stand out. It's probably lost some of the dark. So you have to have dark against light, okay? The darks will really make the light stand out. There we go, keep going. Didn't take us very long to do this though, did it? Not a really long video. At least it don't seem like it. I'll find out now when I get ready to edit and upload it. It'll tell me how much time it is. Doesn't seem long. I really enjoy this painting. Because it's different than some of the ones that I do. I want to do more of these. I got another idea where I'm going to some kids on the beach. I got the beach already painted, so we already did the beach. And if you didn't do it, I'll give you a link to it. What I'm going to take that beach painting, and I'm going to add kids or somebody. You know, it could be somebody standing on the beach, could be kids playing on the beach, could be anything. Now, see the difference that made. Isn't that nice? That really brought out those other colors, didn't they? So there we go. Get your long brush, long liner brush. I find this one works the best. And I'm going to pick up, let me see. I'm going to get some yellow, a little bit of white, burnt sienna. All right, let's start with some burnt sienna. Burnt sienna right here. Let's put some burnt sienna on top of that. These little lines of burnt sienna, it blends in pretty good with it. So you don't, you know, I'm just trying to, like I say, I always say, I'm just trying to get some shapes first. All right. So get burnt sienna, add a little more here if you want. You know, you can have her here as long as, this is your painting, so you can have her here as long as you want. Now let's go into the yellow with the dirty brush. We can really get something going here. Right. Pull it out like this. This time I'm going to add a little bit of white to get that going, get that moving. My dirty brush. Hair blown in the wind there. If you put too much on or you don't like the shape or whatever's going on with it, go back to your burnt umber or your burnt sienna. The darks in between. Alright, so clean your brush off and then you go back to burnt umber. If you lost your shadows or you don't like it or whatever, put the burnt umber back in. You might have to wait for it to dry. I can't seem to get it to. There we go, it's better. The
shadow's up under the hat there, so you're going to need to keep that in there. Alright, so you see those highlights coming out? Aren't they nice? Yellow and white. Your dirty brush is fine. But you can see all these little pieces of here, see? Okay, that's pretty. All right, now we're finished. Unless you can see other things that you want to do with it, you certainly can go ahead and add more flowers, more color, whatever you want to do with it. And I think I'm happy with that. Looks pretty, doesn't it? That's really nice. It came out really, really nice. So guys, if you like that video, give me a thumbs up, hey? And a like and all that good stuff. And let me know in the comments, you know, if you like it, let me know. It's nice to know, and because you guys give me amazing comments, and that's what keeps me going. So thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.